Johnson & Johnson vaccine developed from aborted fetal cell lines?
It is a question many of you have asked the Verify team after the Catholic Church issued a statement warning Catholics the J&J shot is morally compromised. Investigative reporter Cheryl Mercedes finds out.
The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops and Committee on Pro-Life Activities blasted the statement online and on social media. It said, in part,
the Johnson & Johnson vaccine was tested and is produced with abortion-derived cell lines, raising moral concerns. Therefore, if one has the ability to choose a vaccine, Pfizer or Moderna's vaccines should be chosen over Johnson & Johnson. Ms. Adams, Victoria, and several others asked the Verify team, did Johnson & Johnson use cells derived decades ago from an abortion to create the vaccine? We have three sources for this: the U.S. Bishops Conference, Johnson & Johnson, and Dr. Amish Adalja, senior scholar at Johns Hopkins, who treats infectious disease, critical care, and emergency patients, and also works on pandemic policy.
The vaccine itself does not include any kind of fetal cells. However, the vaccine is manufactured using fetal cells, as is the AstraZeneca vaccine.
What does that mean? Were these aborted fetuses from the 70s and 80s, as some are alleging?
Yes, the origin of these cell lines are from aborted fetuses.
Johnson & Johnson issued a statement to the Verify team saying, in part, there is no fetal tissue in our Janssen COVID-19 vaccine. Our COVID-19 vaccine is an inactivated, non-infective, endovirus vector similar to a cold virus, which codes for the coronavirus spike protein. So where do the aborted fetal cells come in? Dr. Adalja explains they were used to produce the adenovirus vector.
And what happens is they grow the virus through those cells. They then harvest the virus, filter all of that material, and what you get in your vaccine is actually the virus that's been engineered.
Dr. Adalja says while the COVID-19 vaccine is getting a lot of attention right now, fetal cell lines are used to make many vaccines.
For example, the chickenpox vaccine, the shingles vaccine, hepatitis A vaccine, the rubella vaccine, one of the rabies vaccines, all use fetal cells, so this is nothing new.
So we can verify that Johnson & Johnson did use aborted fetal cells in its creation of the COVID-19 vaccine.
Dr. Adalja added, fetal cells play an important role in the development of life-saving enhancements. He tells me he has full confidence in the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. With your Verify, I'm Cheryl Mercedes.
If you have something you want us to look into, just post on our KHOU11 Facebook page or Twitter. Also email us at verify@khou.com.